songs. I'm way too sad to even try to vocalize my thoughts. Wanna destroy my feelings every single damn time that I get so caught up in the healing. Cause it's everlasting. Cause I'm stuck everlasting. You could tell. Most days I'm just too scared to be alive. I push everyone away, single-handedly destroying my reputation through the stupid things I say that I can't take back. I am permanently damaged from the results of my past, and it's everlasting, cause I'm stuck everlasting. I could live a trillion years and still feel like shit every day. And I could live a quadrillion more and still never find a fucking way to satisfy the ones that I love, to which I wish I could say, please forgive me now. Sell this broken soul on eBay, no reserve.
Why do you think I'm capable of anything? Do you think I can do all this stuff? But I can't. I'm just afraid. I've always just been stupid and afraid.
My body as a punching bag for my brain. only consistent thing in my life has been everyone leaving. I've tried so hard, I have changed so much, I've evolved so many times, but no one's been around to witness it except for me and my conscience. I guess it's fine that I'm alone, I'm just comforted by the fact that it's enabled me to grow. When the curtain closed before the play ended, I felt like I had lost my narrative vision. All the characters, they just disappear into nothingness. All their hopes, inside jokes, their laughs, and their smiles, they just turn into dust, they just turn into dirt. It just works for me to forget you, and I'll lose parts of myself in the process of erasing everyone that I loved but left before I had the chance to change. I just wanna prove that I wasn't lying when I told you I loved you. Well, that was the truth. But if you need me now, you know I'd do anything to be a person you need. But there's no rewriting the past, there's no forcing the future, there is no way to give your whole soul away and have it returned and damaged to you. Being alive is a hard sentence to fight when none of the jurors are even on your side. So I'll play single player role playing video games until I die, while playing through Earthbound for the seventh time. I don't have much to say, I waste my life away waiting for them to all come back and forgive me. But that won't happen, 'cause they all left for a reason, and I'm not denying that. But if you knew me now, you know I'd do anything for a chance to say to your face, I'm sorry.
Speak to your old friends again. I guess I'm losing touch, 'cause I've been losing lots, and I fear I'll lose everything else if I don't gain something new. Now the emptiness is consuming me, I have fallen through the void. All I see is blackness and gravestones of relationships that have died. I guess that's fine, I guess that's fine. diagnosed with a lifelong illness. People talk about loss like they're the only ones to ever have felt the crushing weight of everything slipping away. Suddenly and violently, every worthwhile thing exits me, including my ability to feel anything. Isolation is masturbation, incapable of any creation. All I'm doing is prolonging my suffering. Things can get better, they'll get worse, and that's the worst. Senses incapable of simple gestures. I just want to show the ones that I love that I will not be giving up again. But the grief, the grief, the grief makes it hard not to give in. Nihilism is wisdom. If you're a person on the internet trying to get the last word in a conversation about things that people really care about, but you're actually the smart one 'cause you realize nothing matters, hey man, fuck you. Who are you to tell me I'm acting like a dick? In turn, I'll never internalize it or try to be something better, 'cause what's the point? The world is burning down. Why would we need to change or grow if we're all gonna die tomorrow? I wish things could be better, but they'll never be, they'll never be. I wish things could be better, but they'll never be, they'll never be. And they never be. It starts with me. I wonder what it would be like if I didn't change when I did. Would I still hurt everyone that I love? Would I still be so toxically desperate? Would I still send mass Snapchats to all of my goddamn contacts? As if there was inherent significance in my loneliness. I spent so many nights chastising myself as a strategy, the drill into my head, the audacity that I must have had to be that way, that I must have had to act that way. I'm just so grateful to have those pills out of my life, to not be binge drinking all the time, to no longer feel like a passenger of a self-driving car headed straight into a wall. I think there's a future in dissolving into kindness, becoming one with the lightness, nurturing a sympathy for the darkness, never snapping back to the selfishness that defined you in your past. You must become a person that you truly believe has earned love.
Yeah.
if you've done things you regret now. In the couple of decades you've been alive, please tell me why, and if it has to do with the fact that you want to be good. I believe you, I believe you, I believe you, I believe in you. Just stop fucking doing those things that you used to. The self-destructive behaviors you've learned don't only affect you, but the people you love, the ones you wish that you could take care of. I think you're capable. So don't self-destruct, please do not erupt. I know it's hard. Just look deep inside, give it a try, and try again until you die. The only way to cause minimal pain is a change. You gotta change. Keep on changing until you're proud of the person you are when you wake up in the morning. You won't feel sad. You won't be angry. You won't be bitter, even if you're in pain. You'll just feel grateful, 'cause even when you're in pain, things look better when you look outward at all the people that you could love. All the people that you will love. All the pool parties you haven't been to yet. All the board game nights you all the karaoke bars you haven't been to yet. But you'll never know if you give up now. You might never know what it's like to be wholly, completely, totally engulfed by the love of people that have no obligation to see you, no obligation to treat you so well, but they still do it, 'cause when they see you, they see a person that would do the same for them too.
Just want to
sex was never the measure of the deepness of a connection. But really, man, it's fine. Just thought it would be cool to be stupid together. It's just an adolescent crush, and I've already said too much. Infatuation is a prison, but I am my own warden. I will keep myself in check, so one day I can be released on good behavior.
just thinking, it wasn't a chemical imbalance and it wasn't drugs and alcohol. I think it was much more that I lived an incredibly American life. This idea that if I could just achieve X and Y and Z, that everything would be okay. There's a thing in the book about how when somebody leaps from a burning skyscraper, it's not that they're not afraid of falling anymore. It's that the alternative is so awful. And so then you're invited to consider what could be so awful that leaping to your death would seem like an escape from it. And I don't know if you have any experience with this kind of thing, but it's worse than any kind of physical injury. It may be in the old days what was known as a spiritual crisis. Feeling as though every axiom of your life turned out to be false and there was actually nothing. And that you were nothing. And it's all a delusion and you're so much better than everybody because you can see that this is just a delusion and you're so much worse because you can't fucking function. It's really horrible. I don't think that we ever change. I'm sure that I still have those same parts of me. I'm trying really hard to find a way not to let them drive. You know? Anyway, I'm okay. Good night.